Good morning, welcome to my channel Fat to Keto. My friends call me Jelly. I've lost 181 pounds so far on a ketogenic journey. I've had a lot of struggle on it. It has not been a piece of cake for me like a lot of people have been able to just keep going down. My weight journey is like this, and I have been struggling all summer, and it's not summer any longer, with the same 13 pounds up and down of water weight or whatever you want to call it. But this is not new for me. I stall for 7 months at a time, and then I have a big whoosh, like a really huge giant one. That's how in 2 years I managed to lose 181 pounds with a lot of stalls. But it's okay. We're going with it. And I do know for sure that nightshades and nuts stall me and cause just as much weight gain, water gain, whatever you want to call it, as me going and eating a Dunkin' Donuts. Or any other carbs. So for my body, nuts and nightshades is not keto friendly. So a food isn't necessarily, I don't like to consider foods keto friendly or not keto friendly, because it's your body. So you might be able to have your nightshades and nuts, and it's perfectly keto friendly for your body, and your body produces your ketones. It doesn't knock you, it doesn't cause inflammation, it doesn't cause you pain or any issues. I'm washing clothes, so sorry about all the beeping. And that's amazing, and I wish my body was that way too. Unfortunately, there's a whole list of foods that most people on keto can eat, and you probably can eat with no problem and lose tons of weight and enjoy your keto diet. Unlike this girl here, whose list gets extremely small. The truth is, if I want to lose weight, the only way I can do it is meat, cheese, salt, pepper, and some eggs, and heavy whipping cream, and coffee, and nothing else. Every time I eat anything else, the water comes on. I am trying the whole parsley tea thing. I did some yesterday, and I ate parsley in my salad, and it ruined my salad because I hate parsley, but I did it. I am down, let's see, yesterday I weighed in at 203.6, and today I weighed in at 201.2. So, I am down weight. I don't know if it's from the parsley or not. It was supposed to make me pee a lot. I did not. So we will see. I'm going to keep trying it. I am on my second collagen coffee of the day. It's 4 o'clock here. I've had 2 pieces of bacon at my mom's earlier just because I was crazy hungry, but I wasn't planning on it. Don't know what I'm doing for dinner yet. Today is laundry day. House cleaning day, because it's nasty and it's pouring rain and I'm not going anywhere. It's supposed to be grocery day. And it is pull out my winter pajamas. So that causes me a lot of washing to do, because you know when clothes have been stuck away for 7 to 8 months, they get this weird crayon-y smell. So yeah, I'm rewashing clothes. What else am I doing today? Oh, I'm getting ready for a Christmas tree. Yes, I'm getting ready to put up my Christmas. So, and to do that, this whole bed, which has got stuff from my daughter's Halloween party still on it, it has to be moved, because underneath the bed is containers that actually holds the mattress up. And that's where all my Christmas stuff is. So I kind of got to tear this whole section apart to even get to the Christmas stuff. But first, I have to tear my living room apart to make room for the Christmas stuff. So that's what I'm doing this week. You will not see me in much makeup unless I end up going out. I'm just gonna look like, yeah, plain pale. Because I'm focusing on getting ready for Christmas. I know y'all gonna say it's too early. However, I have family coming for the whole week of Thanksgiving, and they won't be back until Christmas, and the little kids love the Christmas tree and stuff up, so I wanna get it up before they get here so they can enjoy it. So it is house cleaning, and this room is getting too hot. Like, I need to go turn my heater down. I thought I had it on 66, but maybe because I put the sweater on and this room is so tiny. This room is only like 8 by 9. It is very tiny. It gets hot in here fast. So, I live on my collagen coffees. They are my best things in the world. I really do love them. I did try to make me a regular coffee with some cinnamon. I overdid that cinnamon. That's why I was drinking before this. I took a few sips, thought I could deal with it, but I couldn't, because the cinnamon was so bitter. I mean, that thing accidentally, like, whoosh, just poured all in there. So if you can handle cinnamons and turmeric and cumin, those are some really great flavors that you can put on foods, whether you're making something sweet or not. And it's really healthy for your body. It can help you with bloat and water issues. I seem to have a problem with turmeric lately. I love it to death though. So it depends on the time of the year or what I can eat too, because I have allergies issues, which causes me issues. So 5 weeks ago, I stopped my metformin, which I was told to never go off because I have polycystic ovary syndrome. And everyone says keto heals that. Even the keto doctors, they say you no longer need those pills once you've been on keto, even for a month, and I've been on for 2 years. However, I find it very weird that I've gone up to 13 pounds and I cannot lose weight after getting it completely out of my system. And I'm having a little bit of blood sugar issues again. Not like, oh my gosh, she's a diabetic, blood sugar issues, but oh my gosh, I'm not eating carbs. Why is my blood sugar back into the 120s? So, yeah, I might be going back on my metformin. My doctor did refill them and they never wanted me going off of them in the first place. Because I am extremely, extremely, extremely insulin resistant. I have not gone back on them yet. I'm giving it about 2 weeks to see what happens. If my weight does not go down after being so strict and taking all the nightshades and taking the salads back away and taking the nuts away, if I still don't go down any, I will probably try the metformin again, because it might have made me nauseous sometimes. But this, my sugar being never below 90 all of a sudden for the past 2+ weeks, is starting to make me feel really tired and sick 24/7. Like, I feel wore out. So I'm still giving it time just for my body to adjust, because after 9-something years on that and then going cold turkey, my body might just having a adjust period. So I'm still giving it time to adjust and see what happens. So yeah, so my videos will probably be crazy short this week. A lot of my videos are 35 minutes to an hour, but I'm not doing a lot of cooking this week. I'm just whatever I can get my hands on, that's what I'm gonna eat, because I'm focusing on cleaning and dusting and Christmas tree and all that good stuff. So my laundry keeps yelling at me, so I'm gonna go take care of that right now, drink my collagen coffee, rest for a few minutes before I get into more stuff. Because the weather decided it was getting cold early this year. Usually I don't even pull out the winter clothes until the end of November, but yeah, it was 20 the other day, so I need my pajamas, because I don't keep the house above 66 because I can't afford that electric bill. So we need some fluffy clothes, people. Okay, it is 6:30 and I've made a little roast beef cheese sandwich, and this is my only meal of the day other than my collagen coffees, and I am absolutely starving, so I hope it tastes as good as it looks. Okay, that was not that bad. It actually was pretty good. I don't like the sesame seeds, so I have something in my eyes, sorry. If I could figure out a bread that doesn't have the sesame seed, I'd be happy. I hope this really does work for me. I know a lot of y'all, I get a lot of emails and comments of don't eat processed food. I shouldn't be wanting bread, blah, blah, blah. I'm sorry. I'm not the keto person who wants to give up processed food, who wants to have to be that way. I prefer easy, simple, fast sometimes, yummy. I don't like the taste of plain foods. I love sandwiches. Sandwiches is my weakness and been one of the hardest things to give up on keto. So if this works for me, I'm going to be a happy girl. More power to the ones who can stay clean and be happy. I can't. I really miss my sandwiches. You just don't know. I was a Subway chick, and that's what probably made me so fat, is all the Subways. So yeah, during my cleaning tonight, I'm trying to stand here without crying, I was stupid and somehow managed to carry a pitcher, like pizza, a wooden pitcher, really big, and didn't clear the wall when trying to turn the hallway. It jammed into me so bad and so hard, it pushed me onto the floor. My side is very, very swollen and in severe pain. Everything hurts, even my neck. And I was totally in shock and couldn't get up. And I was in tears for a moment because not because of all the pain, but I was in shock and I couldn't catch my breath because it knocked the wind out of me. So I should be doing a video tomorrow, but if I don't, it's just because I'm in insane pain. The pain is seeming to get worse. And it's got like a numb, hot, burning feeling too. I have nerve issues, so I hope I did not make that nerve worse that I have right there. I'm literally sitting here like holding my side. So I'm gonna go ahead and let y'all go. I did go down in the weight, like I said earlier. I ate another one of those sandwiches because I want to see if I can go down and weight again. I have not done parsley today. I will do it tomorrow. Yeah, I'm just gonna go lay in bed now.